What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of the Digital Logic series. Today's episode will be pretty simple as compared to last time's, as this episode will be about logic gates. And basically, let's look at a switch that turns on a light bulb in a room, right? When the switch is on, the light bulb is on, and that's like pretty easy. Now let's look at another situation. You have a light in a stairwell, and you want to be able to control the light using two separate switches. You can either flick on either the bottom switch or the top switch and the light should turn on, and depending on whether the light is on, if any switch is flicked off, then the light should also turn off. Another situation would be maybe you're creating a lock that'll open only after you turn on two switches. Situations like these are why we use logic gates. Okay, so let's start off by talking about all of the basic logic gates. Oh yeah, by the way, I'll be using Logically for this demonstration, so feel free to use that to mess around with logic gates with me. Oh. So first up is the AND gate. This gate will only give an output of 1. By the way, an output is represented by Y. So it'll only give an output of 1 if A and B, which are two of the inputs, are also equal to 1, or on. Any other combination will give you 0 for Y, which means that the end result will be off. An AND gate is represented by this shape, which looks like a plug, right? And now let's see how this works on logically. We have our two switches here. We connect it to this AND gate, and we connect the end result to a light bulb. We turn on any one switch, it doesn't work. If both switches are off, this also doesn't work. But when we turn on both switches, it turns into an on light bulb. Let's zoom in a bit. Next is the OR gate. This gate will only output 1 if at least one of the switches are on. It doesn't matter whether it's A or B, and it also doesn't matter if both A or B are on, just one switch is required. An OR gate is represented by this shape, which looks a bit like a shield. Now let's see this in logically. So we have our OR gate here. We have switch 1 and switch 2. We connect it up. And then we connect the output to a light bulb. So now it doesn't matter which one is on. As long as there is at least one switch on, that means that the light bulb is going to be on. Next up is the NOT gate. This is the simplest gate because it only requires one input. And what this gate does is it'll just flip whatever you have. So let's say A is 1, then that input will be flipped from 1 to 0, and Y will end up being 0. And if A is 0, then it'll go into the gate, and through Y it'll become 1. Or like through the gate it'll become 1. So let's see that in logically. We have our switch, our NOT gate, and our light bulb, right? We can put this together. And when this switch is off, the light bulb is on. But if we turn this switch on, then the light bulb goes off. So next, we have the XOR gate. This is just like an OR gate, except that it has one extra function. The X in the XOR gate means exclusive. So that means that only A or B can be 1, but not both. So let me explain. This means that in a normal OR gate, when A and B are both 1, then Y is still 1, right? That's changed to a 0 now, and this gate is represented by the same symbol as an OR gate, except that there's an extra line. Okay, let's see how this looks in logically. So you take out the XOR gate, you have switch 1 and switch 2, both are connected to the gate, and then you take this, right? You turn on any one switch, the light bulb will turn on. But if you turn on two switches, then the light bulb is off, right? But if you have both switches off, then the light bulb is also off. Next up, we have the NOR gate. This gate works exactly like an OR gate, except that all of the results are flipped at the end by a NOT gate. So you can just think of this as an OR gate with a NOT gate at the end, okay? So the symbol for this is a OR gate with a circle at the end, and let's see what this looks like in logically. Now, while both switches are off, the light bulb is still on, This is because it's the exact opposite output of a regular OR gate. We turn on any one LED, or both LEDs, right? Then the switch turns off. Next is a NAND gate. This gate works exactly like an AND gate, except that the result is flipped at the end by a NOT gate. And in a normal AND gate, all outcomes, except for A and B being 1, result in a 0, right? And when A and B are both 1, Y is also 1. We just flip the end result to get what we want for a NAND gate. So let's see this. When both of the switches are off, the NAND gate is also like off. The NAND gate is on, right? It sends a signal to the light bulb. But if we turn on any one of the switches, this doesn't do anything to the NAND gate. Only when you turn on both of them will the light bulb actually turn off. And lastly, we have the XNOR gate. The XNOR gate is just an XOR gate with a NOT gate at the end that flips the results, right? You know what this looks like now. We can just look at a normal XOR gate, put in the outputs, and compare it to a XNOR gate, right? Let's see this here. So, let's just connect this up real quick. Okay. So when both light bulbs are off, the XNOR gate will have the light bulb turn on, but the XOR gate will not. However, if one light bulb is turned on, the XOR gate will produce, it will give off light, right? And you turn on one switch here, it turns it off, right? Now, you turn on both switches here, it turns the light bulb back off. You turn on both switches here, it turns the light bulb back on. It's the exact opposite of an XOR gate. Alright guys, that'll do it for this episode. And in the next one, we'll be covering schematics and truth tables. So I'll see you guys then. Have a great day and peace.